down the streets of Sire. There was a time in martial arts action cinema when muscly meatheads with questionable acting ability and almost indecipherable accents ruled the cinematic world. This was mostly in the mid-1980s into the early 90s, and it was a glorious time. And who better to start off with than the muscles from Brussels himself, Jean-Claude Van Damme, in Kickboxer. This was my introduction to JCVD, and it was one of my most watched VHS tapes, well, besides the 1990 Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, of course. Now, a lot of JCVD movies kinda run together and have similar plots, but this is definitely one of the most memeable, and is especially cheesy in all the wonderful ways a late 80s martial arts action movie can be. For the longest time, I had this movie confused with Bloodsport. I mean, Bloodsport is generally considered the best, or at least the most iconic of the JCVD cinematic catalog. Bloodsport is also a way cooler title for a movie than the bland Kickboxer, but this is the one I have the most nostalgia for. We open with Eric the Eliminator Sloan winning and defending his title as kickboxing champion with his ever-faithful younger brother Kurt as his corner man and training partner. Eric has established his kickboxing dominance in the US and now wants to face the competition overseas, so they go to Thailand where kickboxing originated. And Eric's big fight is against a scary-looking Muay Thai fighter with organized crime connections, played by a non-Thai actor in a pretty egregiously offensive-looking example of yellowface. The actor is actually a Belgian-born Moroccan martial arts buddy of JCVD.
Do you play an instrument, my friend?
Eric, being the arrogant doucher kind of guy that he is, doesn't know anything about the Thai style of fighting, and Kurt tries to convince him to drop the fight after witnessing Tong Po kick the crap out of some walls. Tong Po pretty much thrashes Eric, and after he's been beaten, Tong Po elbows him in the back and he's paralyzed from the waist down. JCVD, being JCVD, isn't gonna stand for that, and he vows to avenge his brother. But of course, he's gonna need someone to teach him Muay Thai. And this is when the movie becomes the ultimate extra dose of Garlic Fred approved cheesy greatness. If there's ever been a trope in movies I've always been a sucker for, it's ridiculous training sequences. I'm a big fan of kung fu and martial arts movies in general from the 70s and 80s, and the training here is definitely reminiscent of that. You know how it goes, our hero needs to be trained by an older master type guy, and goes through grueling and super impractical training in order to defeat the big baddie, and it ends in an epic boss fight. And of course that's exactly how this movie goes. Jean-Claude is at his peak of likability in this one, and you also have a good comedic relief character in Winston, an ex-Special Forces expat who shows Kurt around and introduces him to his new sensei. There's also a love interest character, but who really cares about that when you get Jean-Claude kicking down trees and getting coconuts dropped on him? All the training, which is a large portion of the movie, is the best part, and is what makes Kickboxer as memorable as it is. The boss fight between Kurt and Tong Po is pretty cool, but it's definitely not as iconic as the Bloodsport fight with Bolo Young. This fight takes place in a sort of underground ancient Thai style setting, and they fight with rope that's coated in glass shards as gloves to make the fight more brutal, and that was the first time I'd seen something like that. It's still a cool fight and does what most American made martial arts films starring JCVD did back then. Yep, those glorious slow motion kicks, and taking superhuman amounts of punishment before he turns the tables on the bad guy. This is vintage JCVD at his rippling, glistening, muscular prime, and delivers all you'd expect from a VHS era martial arts classic. If you somehow enjoyed this video, why don't you like, comment, and subscribe, because there are lots of action movies and monster movies coming.
Oh yeah, it's good stuff, man.